I've been hand assembling circuit boards for prototypes or small batch production for 15 years. In that time, I feel I've figured out a few things that make life easier and save time. First, put your soldering station away. Hand soldering a board full of surface mount components is painful. Using solder paste saves your sanity and time. Always use a solder paste stencil. You can get affordable frameless stencils from most prototype circuit board fabricators. Trust me, using a stencil will save you so much time compared to manually dispensing solder paste with a syringe. For solder paste, I'm a big fan of Henkel Loctite's GC10 series in T4 or T5 mesh size. Gives you over 8 hours to assemble your boards before the paste dries out. It's one of the rare room temperature stable pastes, so you don't need to worry about refrigeration. If your tub of solder paste is expired or drying out and difficult to stencil, adding a small amount of gel flux like ChipQuix SMD291 can easily revive it. Just don't add too much. When it comes to aligning your stencil to the board, I recommend using a flat, rigid surface like an acrylic sheet or even a chopping board. Compared to setting up your stencil on your desk, this will keep your workspace clear. Once you've applied solder paste, you can put your stencil away, making it easy to put components on the board. Common advice for holding boards in place is to use spare PCBs to build a frame. Rather than do that, I recommend using 3D printed board surrounds that have a lip the height of your masking tape. This lip will ensure the stencil stays in contact with the board, reducing smearing. For placing parts, get yourself some good curved tweezers with comfy grips. Avoid the cheap sets with many different tweezers. They're not worth the hassle. Poor grinding or alignment of the tips will send parts flying across your workspace rather than letting you effortlessly pick them up. Good tweezers are not overly expensive, but make a huge difference to the ease of assembly. I like using the standardized 7SA shaped tweezers. Swanstrom is my go-to for general use, and Excelta's 3 or 4-star tweezers are for dealing with the smallest components. Don't worry about being super precise when putting parts down. As long as the terminals of the part are touching the paste, it will straighten itself out during reflow. This works for even the tiniest parts in ICs, as long as the leads aren't touching adjacent pads. A basic hot air station, like the 858D, works great for most boards to heat everything up and melt the solder. Put silicone baking mats under your board to protect your work surface and keep your board warm. If your board has a lot of layers or large copper pores, you might need a preheater to get it up to temperature before using the hot air. Set your preheater to bring the board up to the solder paste soak temperature before using your rework station to selectively heat and reflow each area. Once your surface mount components are soldered, it's time to add any through-hole parts. Start assembling the through-hole components while the board is still warm after reflow to reduce the temperature difference you need to overcome with your soldering station. Use a chisel tip for better heat transfer and don't be afraid to add a tip much larger than the component or lead. Hand assembling with surface mount parts is almost always quicker and easier than through-hole. With a small amount of practice, you can turn out prototypes that look as good as machine-assembled production line boards. Happy soldering, and I hope you have a fantastic week.